What's good, y'all? Today I'm going to show you how to repair the Mavic Pro ribbon cable, which controls the camera, and the crash itself and the ribbon cable might be damaged. So today I'm going to repair that. So this is what you need for the repair. Firstly, you need the drone. Then you need to order yourself a ribbon cable replacement off eBay. So I haven't even opened it yet. So that, and then you need your equipments and scissor, screwdriver, picker, and a tweezer. So I got a tweezer as well. So that's all you need. So let's get started. Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. Alright, so I got the mail and then I checked, and I basically had this and I opened it up. The black ribbon cable. So this is what it looks like. There should be 1, 2, 3, 4 connectors. But with mine, straight away I noticed that there was, you know, could be damaged, but I'm just gonna go in depth into it. So I see it, I'm like, oh, so it's just right there. So something might have landed on it or something. A better view of it right there. So let's get to the, you know, opening. So all you need to do is take your propellers off, anything basically you can, to get all the propellers off. 1, 2, 3, 4 of them, and then make sure you leave your cover on. So there's 4 of them, and it goes. So we take the battery out as well, and then all we're gonna do is this is what you need. So I've got all my tools. So this, if you live in Australia, these are like for $10 at Kmart. So just visit them, and then this is the one I need. So I'm ready. So I'm gonna show you how many. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. So you need to open this first, and then there should be another 2 screws down the bottom. So this is a bit tricky. You can take it out, and then those 2 are off, and you take it out, so you put the tweezers underneath it, and it's really tough. So you gotta be careful, because it will come flying in your face. So that comes out, and then the next one flies in your face. So there's 4 of them, so make sure you put them together and put it aside. Okay.
Boom, now. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and 4 in the front, 1, 2, 1, 2.
So there's 6 screws in the top. Take the cover off. So take the one off, make sure you put them all together. And one eye. So that's it, that's 1 off. That's 2 off. I'm gonna get another 3. So it should be easy, as long as you know, focus and have good lighting. So I got 4 off now, and because I don't even know what inside looks like, and was kind of worried that I might not be able to do it, but it's pretty easy if you put your mind to it. So there's 6 screws, so make sure you put it all together and put it aside. And then to the bottom, this should be another 4 to take off. And I've obviously fast forwarded this a little. And make sure you leave the gimbal cover on. And you can take it off now, because it gets in the way. So from the bottom half of it, just tilt it up a little so you can see inside. So there should be a little clip down there, should be a clip right there, and then make sure you be really careful not to go all the way. So you get it a little open, and then you might need your tweezers here, and I'll show you why. Because there's a connector here, I think it's connecting the Wi-Fi. So grab your tweezers and go right ahead in and take that off. It shouldn't be that hard. There's a little white connector, so you just grab them from the top and pull it up. I was doing that anyway, all out of focus, so, and then tweezers will help just pop it off. There you go, you can see the wire connector. I'm not sure if it's the Wi-Fi or the GPS, but it's one of those. And now you can just slowly tilt it up and make sure you don't pull it too much because you might break it. Yeah, just pull it off now. You can, as long as you have the connectors off, so there's just get the wire cable off and then you should be good. So this is what the inside looks like. Well, to me. So there you go. So there's the battery thingy and there should be another four screws, I think. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4 screws that you get to take off before it falls down. So before you do that, make sure you disconnect the power cord for the camera, which you can do by your hand. Well, can't do it by hand, it might damage. So here you can use the tweezers, I think, might be helpful, but I use the make sure you take this off, and I took that off, and then yeah, so the power's off. Now you need to disconnect the connectors. So there's four connectors that you need to disconnect. They're actually attached with some kind of sort of glue, so you might need to dig it out, but be careful with it. And yeah, as I was trying to do it, but you know, this kind of rubbery thing that pulls it back in together. But yeah, so pull it off, and there's two, and then there's another two this side, so just pull easily, go underneath and pull it off. Shouldn't be that difficult. There you go. And the next thing, yeah, see, those two were easy on the right side, and then the left side is kind of hard, and it's like the rubber glueish thingy that I've attached to it. So I'll dig myself into it, but I wouldn't recommend this. But if you can find a better way of doing this, go ahead and do it. And that's that. And then you use your now I'm showing the PH0 driver, so attach it, and these four screws, you need PH0 drivers to take them off. Yeah, so go right ahead and 1, 2, 3, 4 and just unscrew them, and then that's it. Shouldn't be that difficult. And make sure you put everything that comes off, put it in an order, because it will be tough to put it back together. It's easier to take it off than to put it back together, because that's the challenging part, you know. And as soon as these are off, they should be free hanging, so be really careful with it. And with mine, it wasn't that difficult, but the only thing that was holding it back was the power cord. So make sure you just guide the power cord through as well. And the adhesive also was left on the thing as well, the rubbery adhesive. Glueish thingy was left as well, so here's the camera. Popped out just the way I liked it. So yeah, that's what it looks like. It's got a little computer on it. And the ribbon cable, so we're gonna dig right into that as well. So that's gonna be in part 2, which is the link in the description. So this was basically for those, part 1 very important. So if you got to this stage, you can go to part 2 and start tearing the camera apart and get to the ribbon cable. This part is difficult. I think taking out the ribbon cable is difficult, but I'll try to do my best to show you how to take it off and then to put it back together as well. So yeah, that's about the end of the video. If you want to check out the second part is definitely in the link in the description, and also if you click the eye on the top right hand corner, you can access it, as well. Yeah, that's about it, or the link on the description as well if you like. Yeah, that's about it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.